Information and Broadcasting Minister Venkaiah Naidu is addressing IIS officers who have gathered at Indian School of Business Hyderabad as part of the mid-career training.
See Rajala Satya, you see Sundar Pichai, or Indira Nui, or any other Purna Sagurti, all of them have reached top positions because of, not because of any reservation or any recommendation or anything, because of their knowledge, which is inherently available. So it is a skill upgradation to the knowledge will always help us to excel better. And this is a very good institution that way. The recent advances in technology and communication space has completely overhauled the way government interacts with the citizens. This change being led by social media has resulted in a new era of governance, hence is absolutely necessary for constant upgradation of skills of officers in the light of development of new technologies. Social media. There in the print media, in the electronic media, there is a selection, there is a collection, there is a correction, and also there is a censor also. The owner censors, the editor censors, the reporter also censors. The supporter has no other way other than go through the content that is offered to him. Whereas in the social media, there is no censor. It has its own advantages, of course, as and now we are talking of advantages. We'll come to know of the disadvantages also at a stage. Then what are the correctives also? So there are no barriers of communication has been removed. In the last 2 years of the present government has taken a lot of citizen-centric initiatives, but communicating the benefits remain a challenge. Social and behavioral change communication is a critical factor in the success of Swachh Bharat Abhiyan. Mindset has to be changed. You have to communicate to the people, you have to educate them, and you have to inform them of the best practices, you have to inform them of the plus and minuses, and make the people change their mindset. Recently, this the Bill Gates met me, and we were discussing about Swachh Bharat, resources and all. He said, Mr. Naidu, the biggest issue or challenge is not the resource. The issue is change of mindset. I totally agree with him. In India, we have a mindset, bhai aaram se bahar jayenge toilet mein. Anandam. Ho jayega. Aur ghar mein toilet mein jana bhi achha nahi hai. Ye manasikta. For that, of course, there are problems. You have to create infrastructure. And then you have to take legislative measures also. And if necessary, one can even penalize like Singapore. You cannot directly go for penalizing here. If you penalize, then people will penalize you in the next election. That's why nobody dares to. But at the same time, Singapore has done it. Other countries also are doing it. So first of all, we have to change the mindset of the people. And then we have to create the infrastructure for the people. People come to Connaught Place from, say, Alwar or Bharatpur or somewhere from Rajasthan. And then they go around, and then they want to go for urinals. You tell him, no, you go back to Bharatpur and then go for urinals. You have to create infrastructure. You have to create parking facilities. So creation of infrastructure, and then providing information, and changing the mindset of the people, they are all interlinked. And then at the same time, to implement the governmental policy, no parking area at certain places. No vehicle movement. The finance minister was asking me, Venkaiah ji, create in some places in Delhi, in other parts of the country, where there is no vehicle traffic allowed. People can go evening, relaxedly, enjoy for a while, eat ice cream or whatever they want to eat, and then come back and all. So for that also, one is changing the mindset. There will be vested interest. If you think of banning the transport in the Connaught Place, you can understand what will be the reaction of the traders. But at the same time, what are the advantages? You have to communicate to the people, you have to enlighten them through a proper method. And also provide them, what about the aged people, how they move in, what about children, all this, what about their luggage, etc. Then parking space, distance between the parking space and the space which you want to keep transport free. So these are the ideas. So you get better ideas and you get exposed to various experiences. That's the purpose of our having this sort of thing. The social and behavioral change is very much important for us. So third one is media strategy and planning in the changing scenario of social advertising. A course module taught at ISB during the training of the officers would benefit in defining the communication roadmap for the government social sector schemes and to ensure last mile reach. Because now, you see, we have now, the Prime Minister is very keen that the money dispatched from Delhi should reach the people directly. Late Rajiv Gandhi said that if I put 100 rupees in a pipe, by the time it reaches Anantapur, only 15 rupees reaches there, 85 rupees is leakages and all. But he could not do anything, though his intention was good. The present Prime Minister wants this to happen. The money should go to the target people. So for that he has brought in this JAM, Janadhana Yojana, Aadhaar and Mobile, JAM. And now you see how the, if you are not able to properly communicate to the people, the other day in Parliament there was so much hangama about the Aadhaar card. Aadhaar card is really doing wonders and is going to be one of the biggest reforms in India. Initially even my party people also opposed some loopholes there in the Aadhaar and all when we were in opposition. Later we have realized this is the best way. And then we revised our approach and then said we should have this. Now Parliament people started shouting by Aadhaar, in the name of Aadhaar, now we want to deprive all the poor people. The campaign started. One after another chorus, people started speaking in the Parliament. No, there is no Aadhaar card, that means no public distribution system, no rice, no kerosene. Poor people are not being as data. What is the real side of the story? If you implement Aadhaar effectively and if you have this job, the middlemen who are exploiting you, they will be the biggest losers. They are creating an opinion to influence the public. If you want to really reach the people, you must have a communication policy. So of course, instantly I stood up and I said, there is no question of making it compulsory. Nobody will be denied the what is available in the public distribution system because of lack of Aadhaar card, but we are committed to the Aadhaar. Already 103 crore people have enrolled themselves in the Aadhaar card. So you have to really have a media strategy and planning. And we must also know the psychology of the society and then try to influence them for your ultimate goal. What is the strategy to be adopted? You have to think on those lines. That's why this mid-career training program for officers, which is covering diverse topics including financial management, social marketing, brand management, digital age communication, change management, all these things are very important. I think they are very useful to you. It is important to project the government's work to the people and the media in an area which is difficult and more often than not, the attempt has not been completely successful. Social marketing becomes indispensable in branding government initiatives to masses through various mediums of communication. What is government? Government is elected by the people. And government want to deliver. And when the government want to deliver, you have to communicate to the people what is available to them. They should know. Information empowerment. It is the right of the people to have information. What is available to me? What are my entitlements? How can I get it? What is the way to reach it? What are the remedies available to me? Now, Madhya Pradesh government has come up with a Lok Seva Guarantee Act. Seva is guaranteed. To enforce it, another act. So, acts, of course, we can go on adding acts. But unless we act, any number of acts. The other day I said in Parliament, what is required is political will, not another bill. Political will, administrative skill. And I add now communicative skills also. You should communicate to the people. You should reach out to the people. What are the schemes? What are the benefits? What are the advantages? What is the improvement over the past? The officers, if they are able to really come out with new ideas, devise new strategies, new methods of communication, then you will be able to reach the people in an effective manner. Unless people's cooperation is there, nothing will succeed. Mere government announcement, Prime Minister the other day said development is our agenda. He said it's not the end of the story. Development with good governance. You have a good hospital, very big hospital with all facilities, but doctors are not working. What is good governance? Delivery, communication, reaching out to the people. That's a good governance again. So these two things should go together, development and governance, good governance, sushasan, vikas or sushasan. Then secondly, the people also should be made to feel that they have a stake in this. So they should also participate. Over the years, we politicians, I don't blame any party, I don't want to be partisan also, we made the people to think in terms of thinking that everything will be done by the government. That's a government duty. Sab kaam sarkar karega, hum bekar baithe to chalega. This sort of mentality has crept into our minds. People will be waiting for even the corporator or MLA to come and remove the cow dung in front of his house. Ye hamara duty hote the. Mera bachpan mein main dekhte raha, my grandfather during June, July, he used to have a tom-tom in the village by the local servants. And the entire village used to assemble and used to tell every one of them, by monsoon is coming. Before that, we must go and repair our tank sluice. Irrigation was the main source of livelihood those days. Tank sluice, tank bund, strengthen the tank bund, and also surplus course. And every one of the villagers, they used to take all the instruments and go and then used to repair and then come back. Nowadays, no, they are looking to government. And government has formed committees, then election for that. And election means correction. This for those things also, this, their activity, their own fields, they have to dug the canals. They have to repair their own this thing. The society used to do it earlier. The entire village community used to do it earlier, but now things have changed. Now this Prime Minister, this government believes in people's participation. If the people's participation is good, na, I will tell you the importance. Smart cities, now I am working on smart cities. I have been to Indore recently. There was a presentation made by the Indore Commissioner and Collector, Speaker of the MP there. There were 1,000 people we were discussing. And in the presentation, we were told the population of Indore is around 26.50 lakhs. 6 lakh people have participated in giving their ideas in online, offline, one way or other. So that means people are participating. They know what are the benefits they are going to get out of smart cities, what are the benefits we widen the roads. They have also communicated in such a beautiful way. Today, Indore, so-and-so bazaar. Tomorrow, Indore, so-and-so bazaar. They made a presentation. If the changes are made, how Indore will look like? How particular area will look like? Beautiful. Number of slides. I told them not only make this presentation in front of me, make this presentation in all schools, in all colleges, and in all public organizational places so that public will, otherwise, idea everybody will agree. The moment you go to remove the encroachments, the people will obstruct. See what has happened in Chennai, what happened in Bangalore, what happened in Navi Mumbai, what happened in Gurgaon recently. It's because total collapse of the civic administration for so long. I'm not trying to blame this government at all, that government or that government, because nobody stops encroachment. All your nalas, all your rivulets, all your even small rivers, they're all encroached. Now Bangalore, we are seeing somebody want to remove the encroachment, so you're crying. And then people try to divert the attention also. Nobody takes care of encroachments. Nobody takes care of unauthorized buildings. And later, and such a havoc happens, media highlights on that. And then we all discuss, politicians, we make comments and all. So we have to create public opinion by this is the situation is going to happen to you. We have to forewarn. And as far as the government is concerned, the communicators, all of us, we have a bounded duty to communicate to the people, to explain them what are the benefits of these schemes of the government. That communication has to be more effective nowadays because there is communication otherwise from the other sides also. So keeping that in mind, my suggestion to anybody, wherever I go, I'm telling, after 68 years, what is the main agenda of the country? Main agenda should be development. Unfortunately, sections of the media in our country, they go for sensationalization. They try to divert issues. But we have to focus on development. We have everything in our country. We have inherent strength. We have natural resources. But why are you lagging behind when small, tiny nations can become strong? And we have to address that. And then there is no meaning in criticizing that party, this party, they ruled for 50 years. Okay, that goes on. But you have to pursue the development agenda. So everybody's mind should be influenced, saying that they should view everything, every aspect, whether it's going to be beneficial to us or as a society or not. That attitude, communication system should be that. By a development ho raha hai, wahan ye ho gaya, wahan ye ho gaya, is desh mein ho gaya, is desh mein ho gaya, is city mein ye ho gaya. Hum bhi ye, in all our speeches, in all our communication, in all our systems, the focus and thrust should be on development. Smart cities, what is smart city? Smart city means comfortable living for the citizens, that's all. Nothing more. Then how do you get a smart city? Smart city cannot be built by Narendra Modi ji or Venkaiah Naidu sitting from Delhi, or you don't have a Allahuddin Adbhut Deep. Just you say like that, then automatically, like Maya Bazaar cinema, new cities are created. So it takes time. And also a smart city needs a smart leader. Not a leader does not mean height and weight and coat and boot and suit and hat. A leader with a character. A leader with a vision. A leader, he has the courage and conviction to do something. If necessary, enhance the charges. If necessary, remove, widen the roads for the larger interest of the city. Remove the obstructions and then plan for the future of 25 years to come. How my city is going to be? What are the facilities to be created? How I take the population increase of the city? Because this urbanization has become a reality. You can't stop it, even if you like it also. Because people have started migrating to urban areas. Even I have migrated from rural development to urban development now. I was a rural development minister during Vajpayee's period. Now I am urban development minister. Prime Minister has asked me. Though my heart lives in villages even today. But still. Because education, employment, entertainment, economic activity, enhanced medical facilities, they are all concentrated in urban areas. So people are coming over. So instead of cursing the urbanization, convert this into an opportunity and make cities as engines of growth. Already they are contributing 65% of the GDP comes from cities. So we have to, like that, we have to communicate with the people, change their mindset, showcase them, these are the advantages we have. This is going to be the disaster that is going to take place if we don't take care of these aspects. So like that, the communication has to really bring in the needed change among the minds of the people. So taking the government work to the people is the main important agenda of the communication policy. The digital media continues to influence the communication media landscape. Social and digital media planning has to be integral part of the government's communication strategy. I am sure the exposure to the officers about the best practice in digital media planning, as was explained just now, around the various organizations across the world, would have provided the required skills and tools to address the challenges in the public domain. Initially, none of us were familiar with social media, and there was not even thinking on those lines. Prime Minister from the day one started saying, no, no, social media, social media. Then he started sending people to all ministers also to educate how to use social media. Now it has become a fancy. Now ministers also are into the social media. Information is flowing, everything is happening. How many villages are electrified on a daily basis? Now the power ministry is putting on the social media. What is happening in urban development is in the social media. What is happening in the housing sector? How many houses sanctioned to which state? When? Social media. Then reactions are coming. Suggestions are coming. There are good suggestions also. New ideas also are coming. The crowdsourcing or social media helps like anything. I tell you, Swachh Bharat. I was searching for a good logo. I could not get a good concept. Gandhiji, of course, idea was there, but you can't put Gandhiji for this thing. So then we went for our crowdsourcing and then asked people to give ideas. At the end of it, one boy from Maharashtra, he sent us these spectacles as logo for Swachh Bharat. What is these spectacles? These are the spectacles of Mahatma Gandhi. Gandhi is watching you. Sentiment. Powerful message. Because Gandhiji is connected, because Gandhiji said at the time, addressing the Banaras Hindu University 116 years back, he said sanitation is more important than freedom. That is such a powerful statement. Yeah, and he said cleanliness is next to godliness. But we have neglected that. We are trying to be physically neat, but we are not taking care of our surroundings. So, keeping that in mind, the Prime Minister has given a call for Swachh Bharat. As the Prime Minister is the greatest communicator, it has caught the imagination of the people. And the Prime Minister told me, Venkaiah ji, don't make it a government program. Initially, I did not understand. It's a government program, he is saying, don't make it a government program. And he said, don't make it a political program also. And I said, make it a people's movement. Isko ek janandolan banana chahiye, aisa Pradhan Mantri ne kaha. Then I realized it, then I discussed with him, then I wrote to icons in the media, icons in the film industry, in the sports industry, and in public life, they all started endorsing. I wrote to spiritual leaders, Gayatri Parivar, Shankaracharyas, Sikh Gurudwara Prabandha Committee, Jamaat Islam e Hind, Bishops Council of India. Everybody started endorsing. There was some sort of competition also. Then slowly the movement is catching up. Now I am going to have a competition for the Swachh Sarvekshan for all the cities. First 73 cities, now 500 cities I have put on competition. The other day I launched the competition also. So slowly, because we are able to communicate with the people, people are coming forward. Otherwise, in a country like India, where you have 120 crore population, still 40% illiteracy is there, and then you have different languages, sub-languages, groups, you have regional traditions and all. Unless you have a communication policy wherein you are able to reach each and every segment in their own language, in their own way, you will not be able to succeed in taking these. That's why the Prime Minister also has chosen a program. Some people say Prime Minister do not meet press and all. Prime Minister meets almost everybody on everyday basis. Meeting, no, meeting is not physical meeting. Meeting is also communicating. He is talking and he is getting feedback as Man Ki Baat. Man Ki Baat has become so popular now. People are hearing and they are also giving him ideas. And then it's really able to influence. It's an excellent communication platform where the Prime Minister of the country not only directly communicates his views on diverse topics, issues, but also takes feedback. That really should be a sort of a model for all of us. The way information and the through MyGov platform is receiving a lot of feedback also. Friends, the training about knowledge, about technical skills, about social skills, about the techniques. Technical skills are different from the techniques. Attitudes, experiences. I'll tell you the techniques. The other day we were all discussing about urea shortage. Urea fertilizer shortage has been part of our life. I, as an MLA, I remember in 1980-78, I always used to raise in the assembly session about shortage of urea. There used to be big queues and some people used to stand in the queue right from the night before taluk office and all, marketing office and all. Sometimes lati charge in Gadak or somewhere, Haveri. In Karnataka there was firing also. Prime Minister one day said, why is this happening? Is there not adequate production? Production is there increasing, sir. Production is increasing. Then the Prime Minister, small technique, he said, this urea is going somewhere. Find out. It's not going to farmers. It's heavily subsidized. It's not going to farmers. Then where it's going? This is because subsidy for urea is not given directly to the farmer. It is given to the factories on the basis of their production. So you don't know, they are producing, they are showing the record, 1,000 tons, 10,000 tons. Then where it is going? Later we found some of them are using it for other chemical purposes, industrial purposes. The Prime Minister came with an idea, simple idea. He said, add neem to urea. It will become unfit for industrial purpose. Simple. This year, last year, no fertilizer shortage anywhere in the country. No letter to Prime Minister by any state chief minister. No correction motion or special mention in parliament or in assemblies. Simple technique. So these are the ideas and techniques where you can communicate the people in a better manner and also communicate to the government also. Government means the people who are at the helm of affairs. So, sir, these are the new methods, new ideas and all. Simply having technique alone will not suffice. You need to follow it up. The other day, you have biometrics now. Everyone has to press the button and go. I thought everything is fine. I went to our own ministry. I went to the new ministry. I found the 6 of my senior officers missing in their chairs after 30 minutes, 45 minutes. That means biometrics also, nobody is overseeing it subsequent. So I told joint secretaries, every week you have to prepare a report and have that picture before me, what is happening in which section and all. So you need to have, it's mere mechanization alone will not suffice. The human element of keeping a watch or interacting and trying to find out what are the difficulties, if any. If they have any difficulties, do they want to have seasonal change of timings, etc.? Are there any practical problems? So that way this training will be very useful. Our friends, this training has nearly enables the officers to acquire skills that not only for job specific, but also the objective is overall development of the trainee knowledge, as I just now explained by one of the trainees. In this era where information is power and communication has become a critical aspect of governance. But we have another duty, not only giving information, because we are from the government, this is an information with confirmation, authentic. Whereas others, they give information, you use some of the TV channels, they go on big, big headlines. Subsequently, it proves to be false. Then there is no remedy. Or if you take them to legal this thing, then we claim, we regret. Media may be front page, mein dalte akbar mein, bada story. Then they have it proved. Then nobody is willing to fight with the media. So if you insist, then they'll publish next day. Small error, regret somewhere. And why is that regret? You have to again do some research. The front day, first day, headline. Headline may not be a deadline to us. But that line has already influenced the minds of the people, in the electronic communication age and all. So government must have more credibility. That's where Doordarshan, All India Radio, and our other communication systems, we have more credibility even today, in spite of all this. Some time back when I was a student, people used to say that Hindu is the most credible newspaper. I said, how you say? So one of my teachers told me, if somebody dies in Nellore, others may report, but Hindu reporter will go to the house and see the dead body of the person and catch the pulse of the person. And then once he confirms, then only files the report. This is, used to be told by a student. This has really happened in my life, I'm telling you. That was the credibility. But today, there is a competition, 24/7, making news, breaking news, good news, bad news, like Khud Unka news. You can't avoid it also. Earlier it used to be only one Doordarshan. Dur says Darshan Karna, black and white Dekhna. But today there is a competition. So in the competition, the casualty is sometimes the reality. So we in the government, because I'm talking to my officers, information service officers, the information must also have the confirmation. It should be credible. Credible information is the very, very important, so that the people believe what you say. If you also follow the method of, I told you, the sensationalization, then the credibility is lost. Friends, today, what I'm trying to impress upon you is, one, we have to improve our knowledge. We have to learn from others' experience. There is a saying, rude saying in Telugu, English. Wise men learn from others' experience and fools learn from their own experience. We are all wise men. So we try to learn from others' experiences. So the training provides us the others' experiences. So let us try to understand from the others' experiences here in the ISB and where you get an opportunity in the University of Berkeley, then you go there. And this training should be used for further enhancement of your knowledge and understanding and your communicative skills. And together, we should serve the people in better manner. The one major aspect of serving the people is empowering them with information, with credible information. That should be our approach. I wish you all the best. You are all seniors, already working for years, and then you have vast knowledge. This course, I hope, has made you more knowledgeable, and in the coming days, I hope to see more and more effective and credible ways of communication to the people. Thank you very much. I would like to thank the Dean and Director of the Business School. They have really made it very, very meaningful, constructive and useful, because I have come here earlier and now also today also. As I told you, I am not comfortable with myself. That's why I am not able to stand for long before you, or not being able to go to the other sitting. Anyhow, I am going to address the students also today. And I am not able to keep the word I have given to my doctor that I will keep quiet for 48 hours. Thank you very much, Oscar.
Welcome back to the studios. Well, that was a live telecast. Union Information and Broadcasting Minister speaking there to senior officers of the India Information Service. He spoke about removal of barriers to communication, the importance of communication to change mindsets, and he said that more than penalizing, changing mindsets is what matters, creating infrastructure to be followed by information. And he also talked about media strategy and planning to communicate the government's social sector schemes to the people.